the SEABL season not too far away from getting underway. Rohan Short, of course, we know he's heavily involved with the Melbourne Tigers and also got his eye right across the SEABL, which is about to tip off in the next week or two, I think. Shorty, good morning to you.
Good morning, gentlemen. How are we?
Very good, thank you. Nice to speak to you. Always a good season, the SEABL season. I know I was getting plenty of emails coming through this week from Ed Redden down there at his Sandringham office. What's the feeling going into another big season? When does it all tip off officially?
Look, it tips off on Friday night with the Bendigo Braves hosting the Knox Raiders. So this is an exciting season for the SEABL. They're coming off their 30th year. And look, it's no different on Friday night when Bendigo take on Knox, because Bendigo probably have had the biggest news story in the off-season after signing Albury's championship point guard in Jasmar Ferguson, who will move to the Braves. And this is a huge signing because Jasmar averaged 23.5 points last season, 4.9 rebounds and 5.4 assists per game. And I'm proud to say I'm taller than him. I think this will be a massive coup for the Braves because they're going to pair him with a former league MVP in Ivan McFarlane. And McFarlane, for those that have followed the SEABL, will know his exploits from seasons past. But he's returning from Bolivia, believe it or not, so I'm sure that Bendigo will be a much happier place for him to be playing his basketball. But, look, this will be an exciting signing for Bendigo, and obviously they're doing so well in the WNBL. It's a big move for the club.
Yeah, and we were just talking about how much Bendigo's, the town's going off with the WNBL final today. And Nathan Stremple here, Shorty, and for those who don't know you, when I first met you, I thought one of your players was giving you a stick when he introduced you as Shorty, so you're a little bit vertically challenged, but your last name is actually Short, and that's why you get called Shorty. But we know you as a coach, Shorty, and you're obviously all over those stats, and that's because outside of that coaching, you're stepping into a bit of a hosting role with the SEABL. Why don't you tell us a bit about that, Shorty?
Yeah, been involved with the SEABL for a long time. I mean, I started my time at Nutterwater Inspectors as an assistant coach back in 1995. So, I mean, I'm passionate about this league. This is really the heartland of where the next generation of superstars come from. So to get involved with the SEABL office, as I have done the last couple of years in returning to Melbourne from Townsville, where I was with the NBL, I mean, it's been a lucky break for me because, as you find when you move around a lot of these clubs in the Southeast Australian Basketball League, they're really honest, genuine, hardworking people who make this game of basketball really great, not only in this state, but, you know, we've got teams from South Australia and Brisbane and Canberra and Tasmania. So, look, I love this league. It's something I'm really passionate about, and I'm excited about this coming season because we have some real stars on the floor.
And you're filling a bit of a media role this season, Hosty. A media role, Shorty, hosting the SEABL show this season.
Yeah, look, done so with Ed Redden the last couple of seasons, actually. But Ed's decided to take a bit of a backward step into the producer's role, so I'm not quite sure what he's got up his sleeve for me. But sure, we have a lot of fun on that show. It's you know, obviously available on download on the SEABL website, and you know, we have a lot of followers, and I get a lot of stick when I go out to venues. And last year I tipped the Dandenong Rangers to beat Albury, and let me tell you, every time I see an Albury fan in the stands, either at a Tigers game or out at an SEABL venue, they give it to me because Albury were good last year and winning the title and proving me wrong. And I suppose that's the problem of having an opinion in the media.
Just before I let you go, Shorty, Larissa Anderson. Now, I haven't spoken to Larissa for a little while, did some great stuff with us on WNBL radio. Am I right in saying she's won three? Is it three in a row at Dandenong or two in a row?
I think it's three in a row.
Yep. And she's back this year again?
No, she's actually stepped down for a year to just look after a new bub. And, yes. You know, that'll be really good because Paul Flynn, who is also another up-and-coming coach, is going to take over the reins there at the Dandenong Rangers for this year in the women's side of things. So, you know, Larissa will be playing a mentor role, I'm sure, no doubt to Paul, because they're very good friends. And obviously both Dandenong and Bendigo will have great seasons in the women's competition, no doubt, with the backbone of their WNBL programs featuring highly in those rosters.
Yeah, I think a future WNBL coach, Larissa Anderson, she is a beauty. Shorty, good luck. SEABL.com.au. You can catch the preview show. It all tips off next Friday. We've got a couple of shows to go before we wrap up the summer here on SEN. We'll no doubt talk about the SEABL and give plenty of information to people. So good luck with it.
Yeah, everyone get out to their local venues and support the Southeast Australian Bus. It's a great competition.